Hello friends, welcome to TechGrunth. In our last videos, we have seen what is Docker and how we install Docker on Linux and Windows platform, right? And we have also seen what is Hadoop and what is the Hadoop ecosystem, what are the components or tools we can use in Hadoop ecosystem, right? So in this video today, I am going to show you one of that Hadoop ecosystem tool, which we will install on Docker. And let's less amount of time. So in this video we will be going to talk about Impala, right? What is Impala, what are its components, and then we will install Impala on Docker, and then some we will perform some hands-on run some queries on Impala, right? And how it works. So before that, let me just revise what is Impala, right? In this architecture, you have already seen before this architecture, right? So in this architecture, you can see here, this is Impala, right? That is a tool which is used for interactive query, and on the data stored on HDFS as well as Kudu. So Impala is an open source native analytic database for Apache Hadoop, which is fully integrated with the Hadoop ecosystem, and it is also a state of the art MPP SQL query engine. What is MPP? Is a massive parallel processing SQL query engine, and which is designed specifically to leverage the flexibility and scalability of Hadoop infrastructure. And once we will see Impala, then in our next video we will look on Hue, right? And we will run Impala queries from Hue, which is a web user interface for Impala and Hive. Okay. So Impala, why we use Impala? Impala's main goal is to combine the familiar SQL support and multi-user performance of a traditional analytic database with the scalability and flexibility of Apache Hadoop and the production grade security and management extension of Cloudera Enterprise. So we are, as you know, traditionally we were using SQL language to perform analytics processing on the databases, right? RDBMS databases. But now we have some more requirement with multi-user better performance, right? And with the production grade security and those managements, which is quite easy with Impala using on Cloudera Enterprise, right? So main features of Impala are that it is written in Java and C++, right? And it utilizes Hadoop components which are already in our Hadoop ecosystem, like HDFS for storage, HBase is columnar storage, right? Hive Metastore which is having all the schemas for all the databases, right? The Metastore, and then we have Yarn for resource management, and Sentry and Ranger for authorization, right? Users authorization. Then Impala file formats which it support, those are mainly text files, sequence files, record columnar files, right? Then we have Avro for serialization, right? Avro binary files. Then we have Parquet, which is now has become the default file format for Impala, right? And we also now supporting Kudu files and ORC as well in the latest versions. Then we have SQL support, right? Which is SQL 2003 and all the SQL queries it supports, with most of the standard scalar data types like integer, float, and all those data types. Then we have also facility about custom application logic, which we can be incorporated through user defined functions, right? We can also call UDFs, which all created in Java and C++. Then we have user defined aggregate functions also created in C++, right? To perform our custom application logic. So these are the main features which makes Impala to do BI style queries on big data or Hadoop infrastructure, right? That unify our infrastructure where we can utilize the same file and data formats and metadata security and resource management, same as Hadoop, right? We can implement it very quickly, as it support existing Hive users and utilize the schema utilizing by Hive metadata and ODBC driver, right? And it also provide freedom from vendor lock-in because it is open source, right? So let's see some what are the components for Impala and how they works. So you can see the Impala architecture, right? Where let me just start from bottom, right? You can see we have HDFS data nodes where we store our data there, and apart from that we can store data on HBase as well, right? Then we have Impala daemon, which is Impala D in the case of Impala, and within that Impala daemon that can work as a query planner, query coordinator, or Impala coordinator and executor, right? So together all these can be installed on a single node or host, right? So you can think of that we are having three nodes here, right? On one node we have this Impala daemon, HDFS data node, and HBase region server or HBase storage component, right? So up on top of that, we have on the left hand side you can see how we can interact with Impala, right? Through the Impala cell, which is interactive command line interface. Then we have JDBC and ODBC drivers, which are mainly useful for business intelligence tools for reporting and dashboarding purpose, right? And then we have web interface, web user interface as well for running Impala query that I shown you in that Hadoop architecture as well, right? These are the main common Hive SQL and interface, right? Then on the right, from these we can run batch oriented or real time queries. Both we can run from here. Then on the right hand side, you can see unified metadata, means it is having HDFS name node metadata and Hive metadata, Hive metastore, right? Which stores the metadata about a schema of the tables and databases or and partitions, all those components. And you can see that the Impala catalog server, which pulls the metadata from Hive metastore and HDFS name node, and then it provide it to Impala state store, which distributes and transmit that all the updated metadata to all the Impala daemons to make them consistent. So the main these are the unified metadata, and we can use for authentication we have LDAP and Kerberos for Impala, and for authorization we can use Sentry and Ranger. Sentry was used earlier in Cloudera distribution, but now as Cloudera and Hortonworks has been merged and they are giving new product that is CDP. In CDP we'll be using Ranger and will not be using Sentry anymore. So on the Impala daemon side, we have main components, coordinator and executor, right? And on metadata side, we have Impala catalog server and Impala state store. So those are the four main components of Impala, where coordinator will be used for fault tolerance and load balancing of these executors, right? Because all the queries assigned by coordinator to the executors, and then all the results after processing those queries, executors will send it back to coordinator, right? So if you are a user, right, and you just run any Impala query through the Impala shell, JDBC, ODBC driver, or Hue, right? This query will goes through all the authentication and authorization process. It will reach out to Impala daemon, right, where it checks all the it perform all the checks for that query, and then this Impala daemon will be responsible for accepting those queries from client, right, or processes, and orchestrate their execution across the cluster. So the whole responsibility will be of Impala daemon. And for executing individual query fragment on behalf of other Impala daemons as well. So in the Impala, when query reaches to Impala daemon, it first the query plant, query planner makes a plan, physical plan, right, a physical and logical plan for that query. Then it sent it to the coordinators, which will distribute the query to different executors on the cluster. And on the executor, that query get processed, and the result get back to the coordinator, and then from coordinator to back to the user. So when executor will be performing all the query, the data which will be stored either in HDFS data nodes or HBase. So on the that data will be on the same node, so it will use the data locality feature, right, where data and our code are on the same node, so it will have faster performance. So these are the basic idea of about the Impala architecture and its components. So right, so now let's just run this Impala on Docker container, right? So these are the steps for running Impala in Docker container, right? So we will log into Docker because we will fetch the Impala repository from Docker Hub, right? So we will log into the Docker Hub using this Docker login command. We will provide username and password or authentication token there. Once we will be logged in, then we will pull this image, Kudu Impala latest. Once we will pull that Apache Kudu Impala latest repository, right, or Docker image from Docker Hub, then we will just run the container for Kudu Impala with the port 21000, 21050, 25000, and 25010. These are the ports for Impala for different communication or interfaces. Like we will be using 25000 port for web user interface and 21000 port for Impala shell, right? Then once our Docker container will be running, we will just get its IP address with this Docker inspect command, right? And once we'll get this IP, we'll be use this to open in the web browser with this IP address colon 25000 port on the web browser. On the Impala shell, we will run that container, Docker container, right, using the Impala shell. So let's perform all these operations on our Linux machine, right? So let's see, Docker ps-a, actually I just pull the image, right? First let's see Docker images. Which images are available, right? Right. So we have this Apache Kudu already there for Apache latest. For that, I used that command, right? Docker pull get. So if I'll run this Docker pull Apache Kudu Impala latest, right? So it will say image is up to date. We are already having that image Apache Kudu, right, with the Impala latest tag. This is image ID, right? So next we already have that Docker container running, not running actually, that is Kudu Impala, right? Here it is, but exited 2 days ago. So what we will do, we'll just start this container, Docker start, and the Docker ID, right? So let's just enter. So now if we'll see Docker PS, so you can see now the image that is Apache Kudu Impala latest that has been running with the name as Kudu Impala, right? This one. So let's just first of all I will go to web browser and okay, before that let's just get the IP address. So we will run this command docker inspect hyphen f is for field, right, to filter, right? Then we have network setting and networks. Within networks we have IP address, so we will check the IP address of this container ID. This is the container ID, right? This is the same. So let's just press enter. Okay. Let me just clear it and run it again. So actually the issue was this single quotes, right? So that was not the same. So now just make it same and let's run it. Right, we got this IP address, right? We'll copy it, copy, and then we'll run the web browser. So our web browser, let's just paste that IP, right? And with 25,000 port, press enter. So let's wait. Okay, you can see that Impala web UI is there, right? We can see here that hardware information with right now we have one core, right, and cache we have one node only, physical memory we are having 4.8 GB, right? On root we can see we are already on root. On admission we can see the admission controller, right? We can see backends. So web UI is running right now, which is limited for 1.27 GB memory. And apart from that, we have executor group is default, admission control, right? We can see those. Then we can see on catalog, right? Right now, you can see we only have that sample table here. Then Hadoop wares will be having variables with their values. Then log level, okay. Right now we have not defined anything. We are just using the default one. Okay, these are JMX queries. Okay, we will not be using this right as of now. So on logs, you can see the log file, log details, right? And we can also check the logs at this location within that container. Okay. Apart from that, we have queries, right? Here we will be seeing our queries, which will be running just now after some time. And after that, we have RPC and session details, right? How many users are, which sessions are running, right? Sessions may be closed either when they are idle for some time or deliberately close, otherwise will cause called active. So where's right, these different variable parameters with their values. So let's go to our command line terminal. So that was the simple overview of Impala Web UI, and now let's go to Impala shell, right? So we will be using docker exec command, execute hyphen it interactive terminal to that kudu Impala container, right? And using the Impala shell. So let's press enter. So you can see now we are on our Impala shell, right? If we'll, we can write SQL queries here to perform, right? If you know the SQL queries earlier, or you might be learning for that, you can try here as well. So first, let's see. So databases, right? We have to type a semicolon on at the end of every query, right? Press enter. Right now you can see we have Impala Bulletin database, which is a system database for Impala Bulletin functions, built-in functions, right? And then we have default, and which is default Hive database. So within this default database, let's create a new database. Create database and test, right? So you can see we just created database here, and database has been created now. If I'll see on this query, Impala Web UI, right? Let me click on queries. You can see here the query has been run here, right? Create database, test, and show databases, right? Those are finished now, right? And how much time they have taken? 5 seconds and 199 milliseconds, right? So like this, we can just check there and perform here as well. So let me just minimize it, make it small so that we would be able to verify this here, right? So if I'll again check, so databases, enter, and it will be much faster, right? Okay, and as date this Impala database use cache mechanism, so first time it might take some time to run that query, but next time it will be very much faster than earlier. So let's clear my screen and run some other commands. So let me use this database, because we will be performing queries within that database. So we have to select that, use test, enter, right? And now create table. We will be creating a table named person, right? Where we will be having columns like person ID, which will be integer, right? First name, which will be varchar, and 255 characters. Same last name will be varchar and 255 characters, and city also varchar 255 characters. And at the end, we will be having semicolon. So if I'll press enter here, so it will be creating a table, right? And if I'll refresh this, so you can see here the in the last 25 completed query, we have this use test and create table query as well, right? So let's just insert some data into this table. Okay, so we will be inserting within that person ID, first name, last name, city. This will be the ID, first name, last name, and the city. Press here enter. Right, that has been already entered now, inserted. So second entry, okay, is not compatible with person ID. Okay. Okay, so I think there is a integer we have put here, right? 2. Okay, let's just type it, right? Insert. Okay, I think that n key is not working. So let's just show table here, right? Show tables. So we have a table name persons here, right? Let me clear the screen and then select star from person, right? So if you press enter, you can see can be monitored here query. If we'll click here, this will also open that in the browser. But if we'll go here and then refresh it, you can see we have run that select star from persons, show tables, right? Insert. So all those query can be mentioned. And here you can see exception. We can see here it's also showing exception. So we can click on this on details. And here analysis exception target table test.persons is incompatible with source exception expressions. So if I'll just refresh again. Journal. Okay, we can see details here, right? On the web browser as well. Query results. Okay, there were some issue in the query. Let me So insert into persons table, person ID, first name, last name, city, values will be 1, and we need to, because we are using varchar, so we need to use cast here, right, for every varchar. So let's just enter. So you can see modified var one row in this one, right, in the table. And then if we'll insert one more value here, right? So press enter, and now if we'll see if we'll run select star from persons, right, and press enter, you can see we have two persons added here, right? So and once we have done all the queries here, we can just run exit and enter. That's here, and docker ps hyphen a, you can see it is currently running, right, up 33 minutes. So that's all for this session. We have seen Impala running on Docker container, Right. So we will see some other tools running in Docker container as well, and their brief introduction, right? So that's all for the session. Thank you. Thanks for watching.